to the other 167. I am Stuti and I bring you greetings in Jesus' name. Thanks for tuning in today. We are glad you're here. Time has been tough lately and what we are gonna hear today is just gonna make us more aware and build our faith even more stronger. Today we have with us Kenneth Silway, all the way from Pune. He's a worship leader at Jesus is Lord Ministries. So let's tune in and hear from him on keeping our mind and gaze on Jesus at all times.
Hello guys, welcome to the other 167. This is Kenneth Silway. I was waiting on the Lord and asking the Lord God what message would be relevant in today's trying and testing times. The Lord specifically spoke to me and told me, share with my people this one verse which has really helped me and encouraged me when I'm upset, when I'm discouraged. It is John chapter 14 verse 1. We will get to that verse and I'm sure as we're going to study about that verse, you will really be blessed. You know, we are living in trying and testing times where all we are hearing is bad news from all four sides. We are hearing about the cases rising. We are also hearing about a new pandemic coming. We are seeing so many youngsters commit suicide. We are seeing the financial condition of the country going down. Most of us are worried about their jobs. There are a lot of things to be worried about. But if your attention is on the world. The world has predicted bad days to come, but the word of God has predicted us good days. The word of God says, for he who would love life and see good days. Good days is what the word of God has promised us. Our future is blessed if our attention is on God's word. If your attention is on the world more than the word, it is very easy for you to be discouraged and upset. But if your attention is on the word, you have hope in your deadliest of situations. You know, it says in the book of John chapter 14 verse 1, it's very clearly the Lord told his disciples, don't let your hearts be troubled. As you have believed in the Father, believe also in me. Now this verse is very important, more so if you understand when did Jesus exactly speak these things to his disciples. Listen very carefully. John chapter 14, 15 and 16 are last minute instructions to his disciples. Jesus was giving last minute instructions to his disciples before he could be carried up to heaven. And he was going to hand over the entire ministry, his entire ministry in the hands of these 12. And he's giving them last minute instructions. Now the disciples know that Jesus is going to be crucified. And they are really sad, they are really upset because they had left their family, their friends, everything just to follow Jesus. And now Jesus is saying that he's going to be crucified. They could see their leader being crucified. They could also see themselves facing death just because the Romans had taken hold of Jesus, their leader. It wouldn't be much time before even the disciples would be targeted. So they could see death. They were afraid, they were scared. In such a time where they were all upset and scared, they could see their ministry ending, they could see their lives ending, they were in fear and turmoil. Exactly like the condition we are facing right now. In such a time, the Lord very clearly told his disciples, don't let your hearts be troubled. Just the way you believed in the Father, believe also in me. You know, when you read this verse, he says, don't let your heart be troubled. Meaning, you know, if we rephrase this, grammatically, the subject here is you, meaning you don't let your heart be troubled. You don't let your heart be troubled. This verse helps me understand that God has given me the power to not let my heart be troubled. Amen. No matter what the situation is, he has given me the power to not let my heart be troubled. And remember, Jesus will not tell us to do something that we cannot do. God has given each one of us the power to not be troubled, no matter what is happening in the world, no matter what is happening in and around you. It cannot affect what is inside you. God has given you the power to not let your heart be troubled. Further, it says, as you believe in the Father, believe in me. If you believe in Jesus, if you believe in his word, you will not be troubled despite whatever is happening in and around you. I'm telling you, it's written 365 times in the Bible to not fear, do not fear, do not fear. God doesn't want you to fear. God wants you to have faith, to trust him. And no matter what is happening around, God has given you the power to not let your heart be troubled. And that's what he told his disciples, even when they were facing the worst time of their lives, when they were going to see Jesus crucified, when everything was coming to an end, their ministry was coming to an end. Jesus specifically told them, don't let your heart be troubled. Have faith in me. Even though I'm being crucified right now, but after 3 days, remember my promise. I've told you, I will rise again. Amen. Hallelujah. So if you're focusing on the promise, no matter what is happening right now, God has promised you good days. Don't be afraid. Don't be dismayed. It says in the book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 6, don't be anxious for anything. What a beautiful way to live life. Not anxious about anything, not worried about anything, but in everything through prayer and thanksgiving, make your request known unto God. Even if you're praying today, don't let your prayer be without thanksgiving. Thank the Lord for what he's already done, not what he's going to do, but what he has already done. Amen. And then it says the peace of the Lord will come in your hearts. Right now, no matter what is happening in and around you, no matter what your situation is, no matter how upset you are, no matter what the world is saying, what the world is predicting, if your attention is on Jesus, just the way as long as Peter's attention was on Jesus, he walked on water. As long as your attention is on the Word of God, no matter what is happening in and around you, it cannot touch you. You will live a supernatural life. You will live a blessed life. And don't worry, you know, you will not benefit anything by worrying. Let's turn our worry into worship. Just praise him and thank him for his promises. And he says he will supply all your needs according to his riches and glory. If you're going through financial conditions, remember, you are not the source of your income. God is. If you're going through health issues, remember 2000 years back on the cross, by his stripes you were healed. Pay attention on his promise. Don't let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in Jesus and see your situations turn around. Thank you. God bless you.
Well, that was just so refreshing to hear and learn that God has given us the power to not let our hearts be troubled. All we need to do is to focus on him, because he has promised us good days. On that note, let's strengthen and encourage everyone around us by sharing this video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already subscribed yet, and hit the bell icon. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram, or drop us an email on the email ID mentioned on the screen. I hope you all have an awesome week ahead. Stay safe. Take care.